that American privilege keeps blurring my vision. Inherited sickness. American privilege keeps blurring my vision. Inherited sickness.
Talk about two prominent figures in the Bible who played a fundamental role in the religious history of Judea in the first century after Christ. These two personalities are Annas and Caiaphas. At that time, the region of Judea was under Roman rule, and the temple in Jerusalem was the epicenter of religious and cultural life. Annas and Caiaphas emerged as outstanding leaders in the Jewish world, and their names appear in biblical accounts. Its influence is intertwined with the plot of Jesus' crucifixion and the events related to this fundamental event in Christian history. The Roman occupation brought with it a system of government that limited the autonomy of local leaders, which resulted in a complex relationship between Jewish religious leaders, responsible for maintaining order in the Temple of Jerusalem, and Roman authorities, who sought to maintain control, politics, and peace. The Jerusalem Temple represented the spiritual and religious heart of Jewish life, attracting pilgrims every year to offer sacrifices and fulfill their religious duties. This gave powerful symbolism and high political value to whoever controlled the temple. In this context of Roman occupation and religious tension, Annas and Caiaphas emerged as influential religious leaders. Both were part of the powerful Sadducee sect, which did not believe in the resurrection. Their position as high priests made them central figures in Jewish religious life and gave them power and authority over temple affairs. It is important to remember that the relationship between Jewish religious leaders and the Romans was complex and often tense, due to the constant fear of revolts and loss of privileges caused by the Roman occupation. This tension provides the backdrop for understanding the actions and decisions of Annas and Caiaphas, especially in relation to their participation in the arrest and trial of Jesus. So, with this historical context in mind, we will continue exploring who Annas and Caiaphas were. Annas not only held the office of high priest once, as was common, but served on several occasions, thus highlighting his importance in the Jewish leadership of the time. His first appointment occurred around the year 6 after Christ, during the government of Quirinius, the governor of Syria, and he remained in office until approximately the year 15 after Christ. During his time as high priest, Annas established a system of succession in his family, thus ensuring continuity in religious power. His control over the high priesthood gave him considerable power in the Jerusalem temple. He was responsible for supervising rituals, administering sacrifices, and enforcing religious laws. This position not only made him a religious leader, but also a key political figure, since the temple was a center of power and control in Jewish society. Annas also dominated temple tax collection and currency exchange. In Luke chapter 19, verse 45, we see that Jesus expelled them from the temple, accusing them of turning it into a den of thieves, thus desecrating religion. The trade of animal sellers and moneylenders in the temple was the most profitable business in the city. The Jewish Talmud declares that the house of Annas was accursed, rich, and unscrupulous, along with corrupt priesthood leaders, whose presence defiled the sanctuary. This is believed to be due to their plots to plan persecutions. On the other hand, Caiaphas married the daughter of Annas, and both families were rich and belonged to the aristocracy. Caiaphas was appointed high priest around the year 18 AD, and his name marked a crucial point in the biblical narrative. Like his father-in-law Annas, Caiaphas assumed a leadership role in the Jerusalem temple and in the Jewish community at large. His relationship with Annas is interesting and significant because even though Annas no longer held the position of high priest at that time, his influence was still evident. A brief pause in this video to remind them to subscribe here on the channel. It is very important that you are subscribed. Here in the comments fixed, I left something special for you. Be sure to check it out. One of Caiaphas's most notable moments in the biblical narrative occurred after Jesus resurrected Lazarus. The news that Jesus had resurrected Lazarus reached the council, and in the council, Caiaphas asked the famous question found in the Gospel of John chapter 11 verses 49 and 50. Let's read what the biblical text says. You know nothing, nor do you consider that it is not expedient for one man to die for the people, and not for the whole nation to perish. This statement by Caiaphas would prevent a revolt and protect the interests of the Jewish religious leadership. Caiaphas's statement was like a prophecy that Jesus should die for the entire nation, and not just for the nation, but also to gather into one the scattered children of God. The biblical account narrates that after Caiaphas' statement, everyone in the council agreed to kill Jesus. During Jesus' ministry, tensions between him and the Jewish religious leadership, represented largely by Annas and Caiaphas, gradually increased. Jesus preached a religious reform that challenged some of the doctrines and practices established by the religious leader of the time, putting him in direct conflict with religious authorities. It was in this context that Jesus was arrested and taken to the high priest for interrogation. First he was taken to Annas, and then to Caiaphas, who was the acting high priest at that time. These interrogations marked a critical point in the biblical narrative. During the interrogation, Annas and Caiaphas sought to obtain confirmation from Jesus of the accusations of blasphemy and sedition. However, Jesus remained largely silent. These interrogations led to the decision to send Jesus to the Roman governor Pontius Pilate to be tried and condemned. It is important to highlight that Annas and Caiaphas played an active role in the decision to accuse Jesus and pushed for his death sentence. His political and religious influence contributed significantly to the subsequent crucifixion of Jesus on Mount Golgotha. After the resurrection of Jesus Christ, Caiaphas refused to accept the evidence that Jesus had been resurrected. For this reason, he ordered the arrest and attempted to kill Peter and John. Later, he also participated in the death of Stephen. Caiaphas played an important role in the persecution of Jesus' followers, considering them a threat to the religious and political authority of the time. However, around the year 36 after Christ, Caiaphas was removed by Vitellius, the Roman governor of Syria, coinciding with the removal of Pilate from his position. Finally, Caiaphas was miserably killed and dragged out of Jerusalem by the Romans. During this event, the temple was destroyed, as prophesied by Jesus. Caiaphas's family tomb was discovered in 1990, while a road was being built in an ancient cave on the slopes of Jerusalem. On the other hand, Annas died in an insane way, headbutting the walls, after realizing that he had contributed to the death of the Messiah. As an additional note, Matthias, grandson of Annas and son of Theophilus, was appointed high priest by Agrippa II in the year 65 after Christ, succeeding Jesus of Gamala. He was the last high priest before the destruction of the temple in Jerusalem, as Jesus had prophesied.